Hi, this is Patty, the Shabby Pink Stamper, and I want to show you my camera that I made. It's a vintage camera, and Cynthia Luhu is the one who posted, she posted a video called Vintage Camera by Cynthia Luhu. And so this is my take on it. I did change up the dimensions a little, so this is 7 inches across. It's still 2 inches deep. And it is 4.5 inches tall. And so, and then I did change this. This part of the camera is a little bit longer than this. I made this one a little bit shorter just to kind of fit the facing. And anyway, let me get started. I put a lens cap on there, and this is a metal embellishment, and blinged it up here, and I put a flower inside there. I think you can see that. This is supposed to be a flash. This is an embellishment that I had, and I just put some lace around it. And then I added this part. This is, you know, where you look through to take the picture, and I just covered that with paper and put some bling on there. This is supposed to be the button to take the picture, and it is two buttons. This is a Tim Holtz antique button, and this was just a Tim Holtz button, and this is an antique button that I had. So I just put them together. And then this is, if you are on my crafting Facebook, and maybe even on my YouTube video, I think I posted a picture or something of all these different things that I was crocheting, and this was just something that I was crocheting, so I decided to use it on there. But anyway, and on the back of this is a gift. The mommy doesn't know. I hope she's not going to mind me sharing the pictures. But anyway, this is a picture of her. She's pregnant with her baby girl, and so she put her hands in the shape of a heart on her belly, and even her fingernail has a little heart shape there. Anyway, so you open it up this way. You pull this, I put a little eyelet there and some seam binding. So when you pull this up and you open it, there's a mini album inside. So let me show you the mini album. The baby's name begins with an A, and here's a picture of her older son, and that's the baby. And so I mix paper. So I've got some Teresa Collins in here. I've got Girls Papery. I tried to use up a lot of scraps that I had. And these are some flowers that Joe Paper Drama gave me when we got together. And they're I Am Roses, and they are absolutely gorgeous. Let me see if I can put this up close. But they are so beautiful. And this one here I dyed with my Lindy Stamp Gang Flat Fabio. And I think it's called Plumeria Pink. And I just love it. Oh, I love it, love it. So anyway, I put a doily back there, and then here's a Teresa Collins from her Sweet Afternoon, and it says, "You bring my heart joy." This is a Girl's Papery, like a metal embellishment. And then this is a Teresa Collins ribbon, and just miscellaneous ribbon. This is from her Girls, Baby Girls, Teresa Collins line. Some seam binding that I've hand dyed. That's that. And then on the inside, let me see if I can adjust the camera here so we can get this in there. And oops, I see my lighting on my... Let me see if I can kind of cover that somehow. But anyway, here are the second and the third page. And this is Daddy with the baby. This is a Teresa Collins. No, it wasn't Teresa Collins. I think it was Basic. Anyway, it was a sticker, and then I put it on top of some cardboard, and it says, "A moment lasts all of that second, but the memory lives on forever. Author unknown." And so I think this is a Recollections, not sure, could be Prima. Anyway, here's a picture of Daddy with the baby girl. And then on this one is Daddy holding the baby girl's feet. So I have a button, I think that's Recollections. There's some doily, a doily back there. And then I Am Roses, Roses. And this is a Pro 31 rose. And then what I did was I used again the Lindy's Stamp Gang, and it was the sand color. And I just kind of hit that with some sand color because to match the page, because that was Daddy's page there with his baby girl. And then I tried to keep it simple, and it is so hard. You know, you just want to embellish and embellish, but I really enjoy a little more simpler. Of course, you might be thinking this is not simple at all, but I think it is. So there's Mommy and Baby, and I think this is Prima Flower, and this is Teresa Collins. It's on a chipboard sticker there, and it says Sweetness, and just layered that there. Again, this is rose. It's paper that has pink roses all over it. This was a toile paper, and look at her. Isn't she adorable? I may color in her little thing right here because this was pink, but I made the paper, the picture, black and white. But anyway, again, these are from Pro 31's flowers, and I just tore one apart and made it a bud, and then I sprayed those with the Lindy's Plumeria Pink. This I got from Archana, and I think that's how you say her name. I'll put it down below, but this was a gift that I had won from a blog hop or something. And so I just cut the back off and put that there. And again, this is Teresa Collins, Delightful. These are some Recollection, the pink doilies that I got at Michael's that I love. But I tried to keep that simple. At first, I didn't even have this, and then I had to add that. But isn't that, I love it. I love how it turned out. And so this one, I just left blank. This is something I found at an antique store. It's a pink sequined heart. And I glued that down there, and I thought Mommy might want to write some memories here. I know it's important to me to write memories. And or she can put another picture there. And that's the family on Christmas. And so I said a beautiful day. And then in here, I just put a few of these little tabs just so they can write out. This is just a plain one. This one is Teresa Collins. And this one is just from the girls' paper line, just so she can write things on there, whatever she wants to do. I just love these little this little envelope die cut that I have, and so I put that on there. And again, this is Teresa Collins. This was actually just a die cut, and then I popped it up on some chipboard, painted the edges white, as I did the whole book. I did the edges in white paint because I did the edges of this in the white paint. And then on the back is Teresa Collins. And I just put white paint on there to make the pink a little bit more muted, but it says baby girl. But anyway, that is my album and antique or vintage camera, and I hope you like it. Please leave me a comment, and thank you, Cynthia. I absolutely love this tutorial that you put on online, and I'm going to make some other ones. I have some in other colors that I have planned. All right, thank you for watching. Bye.